Hey guys, happy Friday. Last video, don't skip it. Y'all get this workout done. Get ready to come back to the gym on Monday. Friday, by the whiteboard. Yeah. Again, happy Friday. Thanks for joining us on this last at-home workout video we'll be making, at least in the near future, hopefully. All right, workout for today requires zero equipment. All you need is yourself, your body, and a floor. Everybody's got those two things. So we're gonna start off with 100 air squats. That's a full depth squat, making sure that hip crease gets below that knee, standing up all the way. Then followed by 20 push-ups. 50 sit-ups, full extension at the top. Make sure those shoulders end up all the way past those hips. Nice flat back, pushing those shoulders to the ceiling. 50 sit-ups, then 20 more push-ups. Then 80 squats, going down by 20 reps. Still 20 push-ups. Going by down by 10 reps on the sit-ups. So 40 sit-ups, 20 push-ups, 60 squats, 30 sit-ups, 40 squats, 20 sit-ups, 20 squats, 10 sit-ups. Every movement is followed by 20 push-ups. Longer workout today, guys, but intensity should still be high because you're moving to different body parts with each movement. So squats, more quad and leg dominant. Then you're going to push-ups, so upper body push. Then going to sit-ups, core centerline. So you shouldn't feel an overwhelming amount of fatigue in each one of those movements. You should be able to keep pushing and get big sets knocked out on them. So 100 squats, keep the intensity high. Try to get them done faster than you maybe think you should, because you have 20 push-ups, 50 sit-ups, and 20 more push-ups before you even get back to squatting. So push that hard. Then 20 push-ups. On these, you really wanna start, if you think you're gonna be breaking them up later on in the rounds, break them up early, okay? You have 10 rounds of push-ups, so that ends up being 200 push-ups. So you going the first four or five unbroken, and then the last several sets, you have to break up in sets of four, probably wouldn't be a good idea. So if you think you're gonna be breaking them up in sets of two the whole time, try that, 10 and 10, short little shake off your arms, go after it, try that. Then 50 sit-ups, push it on the sit-ups. It's gonna be a little while before you get back to those sit-ups, so you can really push it on them. Back to the push-ups again. Again, break it up like you need to, and then you'll be back on those squats, 80 squats. A majority of the reps is gonna be done in just the first two rounds of this workout. So lots of the push-ups will have very little rest towards the end of the workout. So you'll be doing push-ups, only doing 20 sit-ups, not a whole lot of times before you gotta go back to your push-ups again. So you wanna make sure you break those up early. That way you're not, don't hit crazy muscle fatigue towards the end. But all in all, no equipment, prison style workout, just getting your movement, getting a little pump going, and working on that endurance on a longer workout. So getting ready for Murph next Saturday. So squats and push-ups, big part of Murph. You do 200, you're gonna do this many push-ups in Murph. So you getting it out of the way and kind of seeing what your body can handle will be a good test. So. Warm up for today. Guys, make sure you're getting your warm ups done, okay? Don't want y'all hurting yourselves. This is the last little part of it before you come back to the gym and you're forced to do a warm up every single time. So make sure you're doing your warm up. Don't injure yourself before we come back to the gym. Warm up's gonna be two rounds, 45 seconds of low plank, that's up on your forearms, 45 seconds of active Spider-Man, 45 seconds of glute bridges, and then 45 seconds of push-up to down dog. You're gonna do that two times, not once. Do that two times before you get going on the workout. Let's see what those movements look like. day. We're going to put a 30-minute time cap on it. So get done with as much of it as you can in that 30-minute time frame. If you finish, great. If not, that's okay. You still got plenty of work in. So just what the movements are going to look like real quick. You should know all these movements by now watching these videos. But air squats, make sure that hip crease goes below that knee. Full depth squat here. You can use your arms to kind of counterbalance, and you're going to stand up all the way. If you need to squat to a couch or a box or anything like that, then feel free to do so. Next, push-ups. Make sure when you push up, your chest goes all the way to the ground, and then you push all the way back up. You want to keep yourself in a tight plank position, touching your chest to the ground, pushing yourself straight up. On the sit-ups, guys, making sure that your shoulders end up past those hips here. Past those hips, make sure you're pushing your shoulders to the ceiling, trying to keep a nice straight back, and then back down, shoulders touching the ground. Back up, shoulders past those hips. All right, guys, let's get it done. Guys, good one. Last one. This has been fun, guys. Making these videos has been a pretty neat experience, but definitely ready to see everybody back in the gym. Guys, if you've been following these workouts, and you haven't been to the gym and you've been liking it, I hope you guys can take time next week to come by. You can message me, come check out the place, talk to me a little bit, see what your goals are, just kind of where you want this whole fitness venture or adventure to go for you. But we'd love to talk to you about it, see what we got, the packages we got. Love to talk to you about it. So, but workout, it's fun, long one. Tried to get that sub 20, didn't get it. The push-ups were definitely the hard part of this workout. You don't have a whole lot of break on those last couple rounds. Early on, it's not bad. I tried to get it unbroken throughout the entire workout, but realized about the seventh round or sixth round that wasn't going to happen. So I had to start breaking it up. Really probably should have broken it up earlier. I thought with doing all these push-ups and these workouts, I'd be able to get it better, but evidently not. So, but all in all, it's good. It's a good little push. I got to see kind of where my limit was on those push-ups, but it's a good little test. But guys, stay tuned. Hope you checked out our podcast. It launched this Wednesday. We're going to be posting, for now, we're going to post one every month. We'll see kind of when. We'll let you know when the next one's going to be. But subscribe to it. Like it. I hope that you guys like it. Members, we will be posting a little bit more. We'll be sending emails out of kind of what the classes are going to look like. We got a little peek of that in the podcast if you listen to that. But we're going to change a couple class times that we can kind of give a little time to clean in between classes. And make sure we got a nice, safe environment for you guys. But it's been fun, guys. Love doing these workouts with you. I hope you guys can come check out the in-person experience over here at Bell House. I'm gonna say it's so much better. I love these home workouts, and I'm glad that everybody's been doing them, but it really just doesn't compare to kind of the in-person community base that we have here at Bell House. So I love you guys. We will catch y'all Monday up here at the gym. First class starts at 5:00 in the morning. Sign into it, and we'll see you then. Love y'all.